discuss about the AutoCAD software. So AutoCAD, it is a designing software used for drawing 2D and 3D objects. So contents included in this class are what is AutoCAD, introduction, history, modules, applications, advantages, commands, and some of the examples. So what is AutoCAD? It is a computer aided designing software program for 2D and 3D design and draftings. The abbreviation of CAD is computer aided drawing or drafting or design. So aided meaning means help. With the help of computer, we are going to design the object. Next, what is meant by drawing? Coming to drawing, we can draw the elements without giving any measurements, like we can draw any rough sketch. So this is about the drawing. Next, drafting. Drafting means we can draw a line or something, rectangle, circle, by specifying the measurements. So drafting is used to, we can draw any element with measurements by using the standards. Next, coming to design, it is a prototype where we can show the objects in solid modeling, that is 3D object of the component. Next, history. Related to AutoCAD, it was developed and marketed by the Autodesk company, and Autodesk is an USA based company. The word AutoCAD is made up of two words, that is auto means logo of company and CAD means computer aided design. So AutoCAD was first released in December 1982 as a desktop app running on microcomputers with internal graphical controllers. So this is a history about the AutoCAD. Next, why we are going for the designing of the objects? So this is the design cycle. In the first step, that is the need of the object, what we are going to design. So in coming to the first step, what is the purpose of the object, what we are going to design? Next is the specifications. Here we need to give the specifications of the designing of the object, like length. Suppose if you are drawing any rectangle, we need to give the length, breadth, height, materials, etc. Next, we are going to designing the object. Design means we can draw it in 2D view or 3D view, and we can draw any drafter to designing of any object. Next step, it is the analysis. Means we need to analyze whether it is the design which you have drawn is applicable for our final design or not, by doing some analysis purposes or some by using simulation purposes. Next step, we are going to prepare a prototype of the model, means a sample piece before it is going to manufacture. In that sample piece, we are going to testing whether it is suitable for our design or final product. Next, after these steps, the total designing specifications and materials will go for the production or manufacturing, where the complete production of the components are prepared. So this is about the design cycle. So next, designing means we are having different types of softwares for designing. So applications area, we are having CAD, 2D drafting, solid modeling, CAM, CE, and the softwares related to these are CAD/CAM, AutoCAD, Micro, CADM, VersaCAD, and it is integrated with the Troy Unigraphics CATIA. So these are some of the softwares. Next, coming to GUI of AutoCAD. What is meant by GUI? So GUI is an acronym for graphical user interface, where we can interact with the computer. So you are called as a user, and the method by which the computer interacts with you is called as an interface. So it is a human computer interface that uses windows, icons and menus, which can be manipulated by mouse and a keyboard. So next, how to start the AutoCAD. So click on start, Autodesk, AutoCAD. Now I am using here as 2020 version, so I am using as AutoCAD 2020, and right click on it to open. So this is how we are going to open the AutoCAD software. Next, this is the actual GUI of the AutoCAD software. So this icon is called as application icon, and this is the quick access toolbar. Means it is quick, means we can easily access the tools like new, open, save, undo, redo options. Next, this is the menu bar where it has having tools like file, edit, view, insert. Next, this is the AutoCAD version. So this is the AutoCAD version. Next, this is the information center. If you can give here any command, and it will be give the description about that command. So next, it is the standard bar where the standard tools will be available like file, open, new open, save, print, cut, copy, paste, undo, zoom, zoom out. So these are the standard toolbars. Next, coming to the workspace, this screen is called as the complete workspace. We are going to draw the 2D and 3D figures. So next, this left side icons tools are known as the draw toolbar, and this right side is known as the modify toolbar. So draw toolbar is used to draw the sketches, where the modify toolbars are used to modify the sketches. Next, this is the origin, and this sketch and this plus symbol is called as the crosshair or cursor. With this cursor, where we are going to draw these figures. Next, command bar. So this is the command bar where we are going to type the command. Next, below that there is a status bar where the status of the commands where we are going to see. And this is the XYZ coordinate systems, XYZ positions with respect to the origin. If you are moving the cursor, so that positions can be shown here. So the positions of X, Y and Z. So this is about the GUI of the AutoCAD software. Next, coming to the modules in AutoCAD. So we are having three types of modules in AutoCAD. First is the 2D, means we can draw only 2D sketches by giving X axis and Y axis. Next is isometric. It is a part of 2D object, and it represents the object with 30 degrees angle. Next, coming to 3D, it is a projection of 3D object in 2D representation by using 3 axes. It is a complete solid modeling object. So this is the 2D, isometric, 3D. So 2D, it has only 2 axes and 6 views, that is top, bottom, left, right, front, back. In any of these 6 views, we can draw the 2D object, but defaultly we are going to draw on the top view. Next, coming to isometric, it has 2 axes and 3 views, that is top, left, right. So this is the isometric figure, and it has an inclination angle of 30 degrees. So this is the top view, left view and right view. Next, coming to 3D, it has completely 3 axes and 10 views. So top, bottom, left, right, front, back, southwest isometric, southeast isometric, northwest isometric, northeast isometric. So by using 3 axes, we are going to prepare a 3D object in AutoCAD. So these are the modules where we can draw 2D figures, isometric and 3D. So in AutoCAD, there are 4 workspaces, that is AutoCAD Classic, Drafting and Annotation, 3D Basics, 3D Modeling. And in these first 2 workspaces, we are going to draw only 2D figures and isometric figures. Whereas in 3D Basics and 3D Modeling, we are going to draw only 3D figures. So this is about the workspaces. And coming to the functional keys. And in keyboard, we are going to see completely 12 functional keys, that is F1 to F12. So each functional key can be used in the AutoCAD. So coming to the first key, functional key F1, it will help the user. Suppose if your system is connected to the internet, if you click on F1 while you are using the AutoCAD software, it will completely open a window in the Internet Explorer where we can type the command, and you can get the description of the command which you have typed. So it will help the user how to use the unwanted command when it is connected to the internet. Next functional key, F2, command history. So it will डिस्प्ले द हिस्ट्री ऑफ द कमांड्स विच आर यूज्ड इन द ऑटोकैड सॉफ्टवेयर. F3 or snap. If it is, it will be in two options, on or off. Or snap means you can identify the end points, center points, midpoints of an object. It is used to identification of an object snap points in 2D and isometric. Next, F4. So it is similar related to the or snap, but it will used only for 3D drawings. So it is called as a 3D or snap. When the or snap is on, you can find out the points. When it is off, you cannot find out the points in the drawing. Next, coming to F5, isometric views. So previously I have seen that it has three views in isometric. So to draw a sketch in a particular view, it is used to change. So if you want to draw in the left view, the isometric view should be in the left view. If you want to draw in top view, it should be in top view. So it is used to change the views in isometric drawing. Next, F6, DUCS, that is dynamic user coordinate system. So it is completely used in 3D objects. So 3D objects will have 10 views and it can be seen in 360 degrees. So suppose if you want to draw a sketch in a particular face of an object, so this functional key should be on. So this is completely used in 3D objects. F7, grid on or off. So grid is like a mesh type and it can be seen at the workspace background. If you want to on or off, you can use this functional key. Next, coming to F8, ortho on or off. So it is used to draw completely straight lines, that is perpendicular lines. If you want to draw only horizontal and vertical lines, this functional key is used. Coming to F9, snap on or off. So if there is a grid in the workspace and if you want to draw in a particular lines in the grids, this functional key is used. Next is F10, polar on or off. It is used to draw inclined lines at a particular angle. So F11, O-track. So O-track means it is used to track the object snap points in the sketches. F12, dynamic input, DYN. So values, angles and commands are displayed and given in the workspace only at cursor points. So it is used to give the, when this functional key is on, it will give the values, angles completely in the workspace. So these are the functional keys, that is F1 to F12, and I will completely give the detail about this while we are using the software. So next is the control keys. So control keys means they are having control keys, just numerical control keys with alphabets. So these are control keys with numbers. So control plus 1 is the properties where we are going to get the properties of a selected object. Control 2, design center. In this way we are seeing the, we can get the objects, like standard objects for related to our mechanical field or electrical field. So completely drawn objects can be get in this control key. So objects, standard objects, we can drag and keep in the workspace. Control 8, it is a calculator. Control 9, command line window. In GUI we have seen the command window. So that window can be on or off by using this control key. Control plus 0, clear screen. It is used to hide the tools in the workspace. If it is on, you can see the complete tools in the workspace. Next, coming to control keys with alphabets. Control plus A, it is used to select all. It is used to select all the objects in the workspace. Control plus C, copy. Control plus X, cut. Control C, control plus V, paste. Control plus S, save. Control Alt S, save as. Control Z, undo. Control Y, redo. Control P, print or plot. Control Q, exit from the work software. control a new file, control 0 open. So we'll know about the copy, cut, paste, saving of the file. Control alt save as means if you need to specify the specified directory to save the file. Control z undo, that is you can go to the previous step. Control y redo to go for the next step. Control p print or plot. Control q you can exit from the software. Control n you can open the new file. Control o you can open the existing file of the AutoCAD. Next, applications of the AutoCAD. So it will applicable in automobile industries, power plant industries, piping industries, mass production industries, aerospace. Nowadays AutoCAD is almost used in all industries and fields like civil, electrical, mechanical, etc. So these are some of the applications. Next, coming to advantages, why this is advantageable for us. So it will have accuracy of drawing and of an object up to 14 decimal points. Next, it is simply and easy to use. By giving the command, we can draw any simple object and it saves time. So within no seconds of time, we can draw any object and it saves permanently in the system. Next, speed. It is reversing and editing drawing can be done easily with minimum effort. If you want, you can edit the drawings. That is, we can modify the drawings whenever we want. Next, 3D representation and analysis can be done in the software. Next, AutoCAD files can be exported and imported. Means, these files can be imported to other software, whereas other software's file can be imported into this software. So, next, coming to the commands used in AutoCAD, like... So 2D draw commands. So these commands are used for drawing 2D objects. So 2D modify commands. These are the commands used for modifying of the sketched objects. Isometric commands used for isometric drawings. 3D commands used for 3D drawings. So these are the commands. So coming to draw commands, first is a primary draw command. The list of primary draw commands are line, rectangle, circle, polygon, polyline, ellipse, arc, spline. So, these bracket letters are known as the commands for this. So, command for line is L enter, rectangle REC enter, circle C enter, polygon POL enter, polyline PR or P line enter, ellipse EL enter, arc ARC enter, spline SPL enter. Coming to secondary draw commands, so construction line. So these are the infinity line where we want to draw for reference purposes. Command is XL enter, ray line, RAY enter, multi line, where we can draw multiple lines at a time. Command is ML or M line enter, revision cloud. So it will similar to the cloud shape. It is used for the highlighting of the drawings. So command is REV cloud enter. Text, we can text in the AutoCAD like single line text, multi line, mirror text, arc text. Next is table, hatch and gradient. So hatch and gradient is used to differentiate the objects from one object to the another. Next, solid, solid enter, fill, fill enter, donut, donut enter, point P enter. Next, coming to modify commands, erase. Erase is used to complete deleting of the object. The command is erase enter. Next, copy, CO enter, move, M enter, rotate, RO enter. It is used to rotating of the object in a particular angle. Offset, O enter. It is used to copy the object at a particular distances. Stretch. Stretch is used to stretching of the object. Scale. SC enter. It is used to increase or decrease the size of the object. So trim. It is used to remove the unwanted portions. Extend. It is used to extension of the objects. So boundary. It is used to create boundary of the sketch. Array. AR enter. Join. J enter. Region. REG enter. So join and region are used to convert single individual objects to multiple
single object. So means single lines are converted into, single individual lines are converted into complete one object. So explode is reverse of the join and rejoin. Explode is used to convert single objects into a multiple individual objects. So next is fillet. It is used to create smooth corners at the edges. So chamfer is used to create edge. It is used to create sharp corners at the edges. Fillet is for smooth corners. Chamfer is for the sharp corners. Break. It is used to break a single object into two or more elements. So break at a point, it is used to break at a single object, at a single point. Next, isometric commands. So these isometric are used for drawing the objects in an angle of 30 degrees, and it has three views like top, left, right. So by changing the views, we can draw the objects in isometric. So some of the commands used in isometric are line, ellipse. While coming to in isometric commands, we cannot draw the circle directly. So we use the ellipse command. In that subcommand, we use as isometric. So by using this isocircle, we are going to draw the circle in isometric. Next is copy, move, trim. Next, coming to 3D commands. Similar to 2D commands, we are using same this draw commands in 3D and modify. And some of the 3D commands like extrude, revolve, used to revolve in the sketch in 360 degrees, sweep, loft, polysolid, boolean operations like union, subtract, intersect, where we can unite the different 3D objects, or we can subtract one object from another, or we can get some intersection portion of 3D object. Next, slice. It is used to cut the 3D object at a specified points. Fillet edges. It is used to get the smooth corners, smooth edges. Chamfer is used to get the sharp edges. 3D move, 3D copy, 3D array, 3D mirror, 3D rotate. So these are some of the commands for 3D. So coming to 2D commands. So 2D, that is, this is the complete draw toolbar. So draw toolbar, like, we can have line, circle, rectangle, polygon, etc. So now I'm taking example as line. Command for line is L enter. First, it will ask for the first specify first point. So after specifying the first point, next it will ask for the next point 5. So 5, we need to give the 5. Next, it will ask for the next point 4. So this is 4. Next point, we need to give the 4. Next 10. Next 8. And for next point, it will ask for the close. So like this, by specifying the next point distance, we are going to draw the 2D command. Next is how we are going to draw the rectangle. So the command for rectangle is REC enter. You need to specify the first corner, another corner. So by specifying the corners, you are going to draw the rectangle. Next, how to use the modify command. Suppose if I want to use the move command in modify, it is used to move the object from one place to another. Command for move is M enter. Firstly, after giving command, you need to select the object. After selecting the object, you need to specify the base point. That is, the suppose this is the base point, I need to specify this. Next, it will ask for the second point. So from here to here, the object is move. So this is how we are going to use the modify command. Next, coming to dimensions. So dimensions, we are having different types of dimensions like linear, aligned, angular, arc length, radius, diameter. So linear is used for giving the dimensions only for straight line. So command is DLI enter. After giving this command, you need to specify the first point, second point, and give the distance. So it will automatically give the distance of the selected points. So align, it is used for giving dimensions for inclined lines. So command is DAL enter. It will ask for the two endpoints. Just specify two endpoints. Next, it will show the distance of the incline line. Next is the angular. It will use to give the angle for selected objects. Command is DAL enter. So after giving this command, specify the first point, next point. It will automatically show the angle between these two lines. Next is radius. Sorry, next is arc length. Used to give arc length for arcs. Command is DAR enter. So after giving the command, just select the arc. It will automatically show the arc length. Next is radius. It is used to give radius for circles or arcs. Command is DRA enter. Next, specify the circle. It will automatically give the radius. Next, similar to that, we can give the diameter of the circle. Command is DDI enter. Select the circle. It will show the diameter of the circle. So these are the dimensions in the AutoCAD. Next, coming to isometric. So this is the isometric figure where we are going to draw this by using the commands like line, ellipse. So this is isometric view and this is the top view of the figure. This is the front view and this is the right side. Next, coming to 3D figures. So before going to draw 3D, first we need to draw a 2D sketch. Next, afterwards we can use the 3D tools to convert them from 2D to 3D. So here I have used the example as extrude. So it is used to add material in linear direction. So in which direction if we want to get the 3D object, in that direction it will go to extrude. So command for extrude is ext enter. So next is the revolve. So this is 2D sketch. So I have drawn it. Next, use the revolve option and specify the axis. By specifying the axis, so it will completely convert it into a 3D object. So this is how we are going to draw the revolve option. So next is layers. So here figure, in this figure we are going to see a construction plan by different colors in different layers. So this can be done by using this layer. But in this layer we can specify the different objects in one layer and different objects in another layer. If you want, you can use the transparency option also. So this is how layers, by using layers, this sketch is drawn. Okay, so next, these are some examples where we are going to draw the figures in AutoCAD. So this is a hook. By specifying the distances and arc circles, it is drawn. And this object also can be drawn by using the auto circle. And if you want, we can give the colors for the given objects. And these are some of the sketches in 2D. And these are the plans where civil engineers are used to draw the plans in AutoCAD. So this is the 2D plans. Next, these are 3D plans. So for electrical engineering, where we are going to draw the some of the wiring diagrams and electronic gadgets by using this AutoCAD software. So these all are complete about the AutoCAD software. Thank you.